Good morning. It's Saturday, the 4th of May 2013. A warm welcome along to today's United Kingdom talk. Do you know, I've just got off the phone to my friend who rings at, like, you know, just 3 minutes before he knows the show's going to start. Oh, absolutely. He does this all the time. I said, oh, I'm sorry. Well, you're about to start your hobby. He said hobby. Called it a hobby. It's not a hobby. This is a trans-international global television broadcast. Reardon Global. As you well know, he calls it a hobby. I've heard it all now. He's got someone doing his garden at the moment. My best mate, Ron. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah, he has someone in to do it. I mean, if only I could afford such a thing, dear. Fancy having someone in to do your garden. So that's what he's doing at the moment. I'm just going to play around with something here. To see if I can make any diff... Duh! That's it. I'm sorted. 6:43:60, I remember. It's okay. I was just doing something for the live viewers when we record this live. I sorted that now. One more little thing to do. If this works, I hope. Text over video. Where's that gone? Right, okay. Let me just type in a few things for you because you will be able to participate... If you're watching the show live, if it's like Friday morning and it's just coming up to 25 to 11 UK time, then you can participate live by Skype. Now, the Skype username, which should have been there already, is Chris Reardon. All one word, C-H-R-I-S. I can't do this. Chris Reardon. Okay, C-H-R-I-S-R-E-A-R-D-O-N. Or there's a phone-in number. As Wayne in Reading already noticed, it is a local London number. Oh, yes, there's no premium rate numbers here, dear. You don't think I'm going to rip you off like they do on the X Factor with Mr. Cow's programmes, do you? And charge you a small fortune just by ringing up and saying, hello, I'd like to vote for so-and-so. You don't vote. Oh, please, don't tell me you actually pick up the vote and vote for these numpties on X Factor, do you? Right, the phone-in number is 020-8133-6358. OK, so if you're watching us live, that phone number, is that going to work now? Oh, fingers crossed, it might just do. One minute. No scrolling. Ah! Ha-ha! There it is. Phone number, once again, it's a bit small, isn't it? Is that too small for you? Hang on a minute, I can make that bigger. Does that work? Yes. Phone in number 020-8133-6358. Or the Skype is Chris Reardon. All one word, Chris Reardon. And you can phone in or Skype at any time. I'll try and keep a little eye on the Skype thing, because that's next to me. You see, and sometimes I'm not paying attention and I don't actually see it. So that's how it all works. Yes, so Ronnie says, oh, I'm sorry. Sorry, you know, I've rung up. I didn't mean to interrupt your hobby, he says. He calls this a hobby. Sitting here, talking to millions of people all across the globe. He calls it a hobby. What a bloody cheek. So he's got someone round there at the moment doing his garden. And I've already been there. Round to his house this week, helping him. Well, I say helping. I did all the work, actually. Can you believe this? Do you know what he's done now? Because he's got this new fence all round his garden. Do you know what he's doing now? Or do you know what he's done now? He got me to go around and put fairy lights all round the top of the fence. Yes, you heard right. Fairy lights. All round the top of the fence. Why would you do something like that? No, he is thinking of the world and wasting resources. He has used solar-powered fairy lights. So on a couple of the posts, you've got this little... It's very clever, really. It's got this little solar panel that kind of faces towards the sun. During the daytime, it collects all the electricity, stores it in a battery, and at the night time, released it. And there they are, twinkling away on the top of the fence. Fairy lights. But the way he's arranged it, which he didn't have much choice, to be honest, he's had to fold back the fairy lights a couple of times. So if you look carefully, and it's not that noticeable, if you look carefully, in some areas of the fence there are more fairy lights than others. Well, he's not happy with that. So he's now ordered more fairy lights to double up on the ones that aren't already doubled up like some of the others, so that it looks exactly the same. Fairy lights on your fence. Have you got anything like that in your house? I'm just interested. You know, do you have fairy lights round the top of the fence? What do you think of that? Have you got anything that's a little bit, I don't know, eccentric in your garden, or indeed in your house? Then I want to know about it. Now, there are different ways to contact the show today. Once again, you can do it live. If you're with us live on Friday morning and it's coming up to 20 minutes to 11 o'clock in the morning, then you can do it live by Skype. Skype username, all one word, is Chris Reardon. And then we can actually talk to you on the phone thing. Okay, that would be great. Often we get some one or two people calling. I love to talk to you on the phone. Or we have the phone number, 020-8133-6358. A local London number, 020-8133-6358. Or you can do it by email. Perhaps you think, oh no, I don't want to talk to Chris this morning. I don't mind seeing him sitting there all on his own. No one to talk to. I'll send an email instead. Or indeed, if you're watching the recording, it'd be great to get an email from you. My email address is chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Right, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. So, I went round there to do the fairy lights. And it does look quite nice. I have to say, it does look quite nice. Of course, I had to go back round there at night time, which I never do because I'm usually at work. Went back down there at night time and saw these little lights sparkling. I was worried. I was worried that a new British Airways A380 was about to try and land in the garden or something like that, with all these illuminations. Because we're not far from Heathrow Airport here. In fact, we're in the middle between Heathrow and Gatwick. Who knows that a plane is sometimes, at some point, going to see those lights and attempt to land in his garden. It's all very worrying, really. It's all very worrying. Yes, British Airways now has their brand new A380s. I don't know if they're actually in service yet. Some of them have been painted, or they paint. I think they might have painted one, because I had a look on the British Airways Facebook page. They have a Facebook site on there. So they look beautiful. I know other airlines have A380s. That's the really big, massive plane. I mean, I'm very lucky. Sometimes when I go to work, if I travel through Richmond, one can be coming down to land. The only ones I've ever seen are the Emirates ones, the great, big, massive planes. And they're coming down to land. And they do seem to be lower than the other ones, you know? I have noticed that. They come down lower than the other ones. They are just beautiful planes. But with the British Airways livery on it, that is just some stunning piece of engineering. So I want to go on an A380. I think they're going to be in service by the end of the year. Perhaps someone knows that, you could let us know. And I'm hoping to go on one to Australia, perhaps, I don't know, perhaps next year. Although I did say I wasn't going to travel again, didn't I? I'd like to change my mind. I'm allowed to change my mind now and again, aren't I? Has anyone been on an A380? What's it like? Is it kind of, once you've got on there, you kind of think to yourself, oh, right, well, I'm on here now. Yes, it's another plane. Or is there a real difference in the comfort on there? Perhaps you know and you can tell me all about it. Send me an email, please, and let me know. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. I've got this pair of sandals on my feet today. Hang on a minute, let me get one up. I've got my sandals on. So I can't find my slippers anywhere. I have this cleaner that comes in once a week, and I've got a feeling are they down there? Just a minute. I've got the slippers. I don't know where I've looked everywhere for my slippers this morning, and when I came in last night from work, my slippers have been stolen. Now, I've only got a cat. Her name's Katie. And I really don't think she's picked them up and hidden them anywhere, has she? You know, it's not like a dog thing. Eh? One of my friends has got a beautiful dog. It's called Oscar. His name's Richard. And he does a little bit of drag, okay, at a pub. And I was with him last night. He brings his dog, Oscar. Beautiful dog. So friendly. The only thing is, I seem to be extremely allergic to this particular dog. So he's in the dressing room. I'm at the DJ box. And I'm sneezing. I'm all the blooming time. Eye streaming. You've only got to touch a pet if you're allergic to an animal and touch your eye and that comes right up and stays up all night long. Awful. So has anyone seen my slippers? Perhaps a ghost has moved them. Is it you that's moved my slippers? I do hope not. I should be very upset with you if you've been hiding my slippers all over the place. Dallas, I have some extremely good news, boys and girls. As from Carl Waring, thank you very much for writing in, Carl, who informs us that a third series of Dallas has been commissioned by American cable television company TNT. This is fantastic news. Absolutely fantastic news. The only thing is, will Channel 5 show it or not? Because the viewing figures here in the UK for Dallas have been absolutely disastrous. I think there's something like 380,000 people watching it. And it's apparently an expensive programme to buy in. Now, Channel 5 here in the UK were showing the programme at 9 o'clock. And it started last September, opening to 3 million people, which for Channel 5 is bloody good. I mean, it really is. They got some rubbish on Channel 5. They really have. But then they had Dallas. 3 million people watched it. Unfortunately, as the series went on, we call TV programmes here, a load of TV programmes, a series, not a season. I have noticed some English people calling it a season. It's not a season. It's a season in America. Here, it's a series. Do try and learn the Queen's English. I've just realised my mirror ball isn't turning behind me. Just a moment. We can't have that. Oh, my God. 1 second. And the lights. Do you want the lights? Do you want the pretty lights? There we are. Let's just stop those flashing. Sorry. There's so much to do before I come on, I forgot to do that. Sorry about that. There we are, the mirror ball is turning behind me now. That's better, isn't it? I feel much more comfortable now. Yes, the viewing, they started off with 3 million. And as the series went on, it got less and less. And it stabilised now at about 380,000 or something like that. So really, the viewing figures here in the UK are really disastrous on Channel 5. They were so bad that they pushed the programme back from 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. And, of course, that made it even worse. However, it seems to have stabilised at about... did I say 380? No, it's not. It seems to now have stabilised at about 340,000 viewers, but it's not enough. And I have this dreadful feeling that Channel 5 are not going to pick it up next year unless they get some sort of big discount. And it's a great shame. However, if you're in the States, TNT will be showing you season 3. Season 3, okay? Season 3. And I hope there is some way of watching it here as well. Now, I remember sitting here doing this show about a year or so ago. No, actually, back in... yes, when they started showing Dallas first in the US, about a year ago, somebody sent me a link to how to watch it and other American programmes for free on the internet. I cannot find this link anywhere for love of money. So if you know where that was, please do let me know, OK? By email, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Where can I watch the next series of Dallas in case... I like to be prepared. In case it doesn't come on Channel 5, please let us know, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. If you saw Wednesday's show... You'll know we'll only be going, we're dropping down to one show a week for the summer, simply because it's summer and there's lots to do. I've taken up quite a bit of gardening and stuff like that. And to be honest, I'm having trouble fitting everything into my week. So last year we actually stopped completely for the summer and picked up again in, I think it was September, October. This year we'll just drop down to one show and keep it going. If that's all right with you, well, I'm sorry, it'll have to be, won't it? I've got the time. I can't afford the time to sit here and chat inane gossip about rubbish all the time. Although I shall miss you. Just once a week. So it's just once a week. So pick up the recorded show on Saturday, or indeed you can join us every Friday. If you're wondering where to click on Friday mornings at 10:30 for the live show, simply go into the main United Kingdom Talk website, unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Look at the top there and it will tell you where to click. All right. I was a little bit worried as well today. Do you remember? If you were watching Wednesday's show, you'll know that I have booked an appointment at the dentist. I haven't been for about a year and a half, and it's all very worrying. However, my best mate tells me that it's not for today. It's for next Friday. Now, I don't know if this is good or bad, to be honest. On one hand, of course, I don't have to go there now. On the other hand, it's another week of worry, isn't it? So I don't know if it's good or bad. However, I am kind of quite pleased that I haven't got to go today. So just another week. But a week of worry. What is he going to find in my mouth? What many holes is he going to discover? What cavities will his little drill fall down into? All very worrying. I haven't been for a year and a half because the last time they did fill-ins and they were just painful all the time. Had the car service this week. £119. Very good service. A couple of incidents of very good service I want to tell you about this week. First of all, Toyota in Bracknell. I think the company's name is Jemco or something. J-E-M-C-O. Who on earth thought of that name for a car company? I don't know. But there we are. It's called Jemco. I just call it Toyota Bracknell. Very good. Went in there at 11:30. It was all done by about 10:45. Paid me £119 and off I went. Quite happy, actually. I thought that was very reasonable. The staff in there are great. They really treat you with respect. You feel like a valued customer. And it's all very different, of course, from taking your car in to be serviced, say, 10, 15 years ago. Do you remember doing that? When you'd sit in this waiting room with hard seats, maybe take a newspaper in there. People would be smoking in the room. There'd be a tea machine there, which you had to pay for. Not in Toyota Bracknell. It's very, very nice in there now. You go in there, so you hand your key over. They're all sitting there in tyres and all that. Again, that's another thing. You know, the presentation of the staff behind the counter. All very nicely presented. Not some old, you know, mechanic comes out with a fag hanging out of his mouth. Cigarette hanging out of his mouth. Greasy hair and face. Black marks all over where he's been working. Oh no, we don't have any of that in Toyota. So you hand your keys over to someone in a suit. It's usually Carl or another lady. I can't remember the other lady's name now, who I always get on with like a house on fire. I think she secretly looks forward to me coming in and creating havoc. I really do. I'm sure she does look forward to me coming in. Eh? And we have a good old chat. And we chat. Well, actually, she listens and I chat. Which is quite nice. And I just chat and I chat. And sometimes I'm talking to her and I see her eyes are glazing over. So I can't even, kind of people falling asleep at work. So then I'll go over to the table and help myself to a free cup of tea from the tea machine. Now, the only thing is that tea machine, you press this button and hot water comes out and goes in your cup with the tea bag, right? But it's not boiling. However, if it's free, I don't mind too much. It's not really a proper cup of tea because you have to put boiling water on your tea bag. So I sit there with my cup of tea. They've got a nice widescreen 40 or 50 inch telly on the wall in front of me. And just sit there and watch that. Read one of the free complimentary papers. And then I was a bit naughty because outside I thought, beep, 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 outside. I'm like, what on earth is going on there? And the lady behind the counter told me, oh, that's the lady who does the sandwiches and the crisps. She comes round in a van, this woman, and she opens her doors, and there you have sandwiches and crisps and sweets and all that. So I ran out with my little wallet. And I was very naughty, and I purchased a bag of cheese and onion crisps and a caramel flapjack and sat there with my cup, I had two cups of tea in the end, all complimentary, of course. And I purchased those two items, so I was a little bit naughty with that. So very good service in there. As indeed was the service I got in Staples in Slough yesterday. Slough is in Berkshire as well. It's not too far away from where I live, about half an hour down the motorway. I needed to buy some pens, some paper, because I was completely out of paper almost, and a new chair, which I am sitting on at the moment, my new fabric chair. Very nice. Not a bad price, I have to say. 60 quid, that's all it was. That's not bad. You have to put it together yourself. And actually, it was quite easy. Now, I'm not one who actually, I don't actually enjoy putting furniture together. You know, I'd rather pay an extra 20 quid and have someone bring it round, ready-made, plonk it in the corner, done. All this mucking about with screwdrivers and Allen keys and all that business, I want it to be ready done. But it's very difficult to find anything that's actually ready-made anymore. Or maybe I'm going to the wrong shops. So I went to Staples, and there in front of me, they had all these different chairs laid out. So I sat in a few of them and decided which one was the best one. And that was the one that was £300. And I'm not spending £300 on an office chair, dear. Although the last one I had was £300. Do you remember that? It's actually in the room next door. I'm going to try and fix that. All it needs is one of those air cylinders. I think they're pneumatic airlifts. I think it's called a pneumatic airlift or something like that. And it's like a cartridge type affair. And what's happened is it's gone. You know, after 13 years of my fat ass sitting on it, it has finally stopped working. Pardon? Don't be rude about my fatness, please. Thank you. So I think that's all it needs. So I'm going to, after I finish the show and put the recording together, I'm going to turn it upside down and see how to get the old one out. If it's anything like putting because the new chair, of course, it all comes in bits. And a very good, actually a very good instruction book. I was able to put this chair together with no problem at all. Took me about 20 minutes altogether, and there we are. But the air thing, you've got the legs on the bottom, right? Five legs on the bottom, like a star shape. And then in the middle is a hole, and you drop this air cylinder thing in there, and then put this plastic thing on, and then put the chair on top, and basically that's it. So if that was so easy to put together, then I would imagine the old one from that would be easy to get out. Of course, finding one to buy might be another thing. Now, the only place I've found so far that sell them, are they called pneumatic air cylinders? I don't know. I don't actually know what they're called. Anyone know? The only place I've found them so far is on eBay. And it looks like you've got to order them somewhere, like from Korea. I mean, what are they going to send me out from Korea? There might be a bomb in the thing, dear. It could be sending me a nuclear bomb in the post. And here I put it on my chair, sit on it, kaboom! There'd be pieces of me floating all over the world, dear. So I'm a bit worried about ordering anything from Korea. Do you know anywhere perhaps that I could order something like a pneumatic air, whatever you call it now? Do let us know, okay? chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. So I put the chair together. Quite pleased about that. But going back to Staples again, so I found some pens. And fortunately, they've got a special offer on the pens. £1 for 12. Now, I get through a lot of pens because I do quiz nights and karaoke nights, as most of you already know. The only thing is, these thieving bastards nick my pens all the time. I must lose 15 to 20 pens on each gig. Seriously, what on earth did they do with them all? Because they're not like top quality pens. You can't put quality pens out because they all nick them. So I was quite pleased with that buying those. And then, not only that, but I found my paper. A ream of HP paper was something like £2.39. You get 500 sheets for £2.39. So I was quite pleased about that. So I bought 10 of those and I bought the chair. But the service in there was really good. Really good. The bloke says, I says to the bloke, what do I do? How do I order the chair? Which one do you want? So he showed me this one. I said, have you got it in blue? He said, yes, that one you've got, this one I'm sitting on now, the new one, cost me £60, which I thought was damn good. But if I wanted it in blue, it would be £200. Don't get that. So obviously I didn't buy the blue one. I just stuck with the £60 grey one. But he took it out and he said, I'll put it by the cash register for you. Okay. I said, have you got a trolley? I can take it out. And he said, don't worry about that, sir. Come and find me when you're ready and I'll take it all out to the car. So once I'd paid for the stuff, not only did he take this out, he also took the paper out as well because that was quite heavy as well. How fantastic is that? Very, very good service in what was it called now? Was it called? Staples in Slough. Very, very impressed indeed. So that was my day yesterday. Now we've got an email coming from John. Hello, John. You don't say where you are, John. Oh, hang on. Is it John in Croydon? Is it John in Croydon? I don't know. Morning, Chris. He says, I know people ask God why cancer exists and why he allows Coldplay to ever have been allowed on the radio. I have to tell you that there is one song by Coldplay I like, Fix You. For many years, there was a lady called Gwen who used to come round to my karaoke nights. She indeed died about two, must be coming up to 3 years ago now. And funnily enough, but she had cancer. She died of cancer. And she was a wonderful woman. She was, do you know, I'm trying to remember her name, her age. I think she was about 75 to 80, somewhere in that bracket. And she had never been ill. I bumped into her when I was working at a place in Camden Town doing the karaoke there. And she came in one night and from that moment we just hit it off. And she followed us around for quite a few years to the karaoke nights and indeed occasionally the bingo nights that I used to run. She was a wonderful woman and I mentioned her because the song I will always remember her singing is Fix You by Coldplay. Bit of a dreary old song. When you find that da-da-da don't succeed. And she would sing it. Always brought me to tears, really. She's not with us any longer though. Gwen, so a little memory thing there from my friend Gwen I was telling you about. Dr. John says, but what is the purpose of that horrid yellow gunk that sticks your eyes together in the morning? Well, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't get any gunk in my eyes. You must have some sort of eye disease there or something, Dr. John. And if you're a doctor, you should bloody well know about these things, shouldn't you? Eh? I should be asking you, my almonds. For example, why is my voice not coming out properly this morning? As you can well hear yourself. The voice is not coming out properly this morning, is it? No, it's not. Why? Come on, Dr. John, tell me why my voice is not emanating from my mouth this morning. It's stuck there somewhere. So I've no idea what that horrid yellow gunk is. Why don't you just say a couple of prayers to God and perhaps he'll answer them and tell you. Perhaps if you prayed before you went to sleep at night, as indeed I do every night, then in the morning there might be a little note on your bedside cabinet or if you're poor, on the floor next to your bed, which may or may not be raised up. Or have you got a bed? Oh, no, you haven't got a bed in the corner of a like an unheated room or something like that, have you? Oh, I'm sorry, John, I didn't mean to offend you. Have you? Have you got a bed that's not on legs on a floor in a corner of someone's house? Is that right? Anyway, Dr. John. He says, plus, disappearance of slippers and mirror ball may be related in a cosmic way. You could be right. Oh, I'm a great believer in spirits and cosmic things. Yes, I am. I believe in spirits. I have experienced spirits before. Thank you. And they are to be treated with respect, spirits. I've spoken to spirits. If I feel there is a presence, I will attempt communication by talking. Yes, that's not a joke. I do believe in spirits. He says, or did that picture of Bazza scare them off? You mean the great Barry Manilow behind me in his May picture? With his little ear thing on so he can hear things that are going. Is that so they can hear the music when they're singing? Barry Manilow. Thank you, Dr. John. Is it you, John, in Croydon? I'm not sure who you are, Dr. John. A bit concerned about that. Thank you, John. Chris at UnitedKingdomTalk.co.uk is my email address. You can call in if you want. If you're watching us live, the call in on Skype is Chris Reardon, all one word, Chris Reardon, or by phone, local London number 020-8133-6358. 020-8133-6358. Now, as I said to you, we're playing with a new little bit of software today, which I can show pictures and things like that. I want to read you this wonderful email from regular correspondent Anita, who is a huge Barry Manilow fan. First of all, I must tell you that Anita really... Anita has been to see Barry Manilow. She had the platinum experience, right? That means, just a second, what am I doing now? Have I done something wrong? No, I haven't done something wrong. Platinum experience is where you go, you actually get to meet Barry and you have a champagne reception and photograph done with him and all that business. And she also had a tattoo done by Barry, and she sent me a picture of the tattooist, who is rather stunning. Absolutely lovely. Little tattooist. Can't remember what his name was. She did tell me what his name was. He actually looks like someone I know, whose name is Raf. Hey? Hello? Could you... You couldn't hear what I was saying then, could you? Sorry about that. I just realised you couldn't hear what I was saying when there was a picture of the tattooist, who was rather good looking. Let me see if I can work that this time. No, maybe not. Maybe I can't work that like that. Let me just try that again. One second. Does that work? No. Oh, can't hear me when I show you that picture. Well, that's annoying. Anyway, that's the tattooist. And Anita writes, "Hi, Chris. I sent this message to you, but I didn't know didn't add the talk to the address, so we didn't get it. But it's here now. Don't worry, don't worry. I know you saw the pictures of myself and Barry on Facebook." Yes, I did. She's taken loads of pictures because she went to see Barry Manilow in person. Cost a lot of money, but it's a charity thing, so we don't mind about that. Let me just try this. Does that oh dear. Now that cuts the sound out, doesn't it? I wasn't doing that when I was testing it earlier on. How annoying. Never mind, we'll carry on. As you can see, there was much happiness in that room. Barry was waiting for me with outstretched hand. This tall and elegant man was so impressive. asking where I was from and if I sang or played an instrument, because I was from Nashville, as he played the air guitar. There were several more questions and answers. This is on her meeting with Barry, you see. I was the last person to meet Barry out of the 12 women that were there. Knowing I was getting short on time, I told Barry I had something I needed to show him. Pulling up my sleeve to show him my tattoo, Barry was overwhelmed because she's had this tattoo put on her arm. Like a Barry Manilow tattoo. Yes. The Barry Manilow tattoo. I wonder if I've got any I'll ever have any fans that will put a tattoo of me on them somewhere. I wonder where they'd put it. Pardon? Asking if it was real, said Barry. Did it hurt? The answer was yes to both questions. Calling over the other three people in the room to see it. Oh, does he have more people in the room at the same time? What are they doing then, Anita, the other people in the room? I wonder what they're doing, the other people in the room. They asked the same questions. Adding this to my tribute to Barry. Because I love and admire this man so much, Barry wanted a picture of the tattoo, so he instructed the photographer to make sure that Anita got a copy. So Barry Manilow actually asked for a picture of our tattoo. Fantastic. There is always one formal picture made, but luckily I got two. I've got one of them here. Picture of Barry and Anita. Calling over Barry, I explained the meaning of the symbols around the tattoo. Stars, because he is a star. Music notes, because he makes music and is music. Heart music notes, because he puts a song in my heart. To that he replied, Anita, you are too much. Adding that, you are my favourite. It was time for the concert to begin. Oh, I see. So I thought you met Barry after the concert. So you meet him before the concert. It was time for the concert to begin because you get to see Barry obviously first, and then you get to go to the Barry Manilow concert. It was time for the concert to begin. So one last hug and a sad goodbye. I was escorted along with the other ladies to our front row seats with about 13,000 people watching us. What an awesome experience. Oh, I like that. To be ushered to a front seat while everyone is looking at you, wanting to be sitting in that front seat in front of Barry Manilow. I'd like that very much, Anita, I think. Barry soon made his appearance on stage to thundering applause and screams from all the ladies there. What a concert this man put on for us. He was on stage for an hour and a half non-stop. That's right, yeah, when you go and see a Barry Manilow concert, he doesn't stop. It goes on the whole night. Like, it really does, yeah. Singing all the old and wonderful songs that only Barry can sing. He looked fantastic. Sounded fantastic. He sent the audience into a frenzy. Such a night for me was the 27th of April 2013. We had such a good time. Barry had such a good time. But all good things must come to an end. And sadly, the concert ended. Yeah, I must say, the four times that I've been to see, four times so far, I hope there will be many more times. I've been to see Barry 4 times. I hope there will be many more. But I always get a bit sad at the end. I do, because I just want the concert to go on and on. No one came away disappointed, especially me. This was my dream come true, and Barry fulfilled it from meeting to concert stage. His voice was magnificent. Barry is magnificent. Such a gentleman and entertainer is this man called Barry Manilow. To be a fanilow is such an honour, and I am one forever. All the planning, all the waiting is now over, but a lifetime of memories lives on in my heart for now and for always. Wow. You've had a great time, haven't you? At Mr. Manilow's concert. And I'm the same. You know, often in my car, really generally, 98% of the time, it's I play the Barry Manilow London concert 2011, the one with the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra. You know, just sit there and picture in my mind when I was sitting there, just with all these people watching this magnificent show. Well, Chris, that's my platinum story. Enjoyed sharing my fabulous Barry Manilow experience with you. I'm still in my Barry days. Take care, my friend Anita from Tennessee. P.S. Forgot to add that with the concert... was in Duluth, Georgia. Also need to add that we had a special room set up for us with champagne and water, plus a souvenir and a glow stick. Or what was the souvenir? You haven't told me what the souvenir is, Anita. Tell me what the souvenir is. We were treated like queens. All I needed was a crown. Such an awesome night. And as I say, that's from Anita in Tennessee. Is that where Elvis was from? Is it Nashville, Tennessee, Elvis was from as well? You've got all the big stars there, haven't you? So thanks for sharing that, Anita. What a wonderful experience. You and Barry Manilow and a picture of you together there. Actually, you can hear me, can't you? So you can hear me talking over a picture. I've just realised that. And you've got the Barry Manilow tattoo, which she had done. The Manilow tattoo, and the tattooist who did the tattoo, who I'd like to meet. I think, is he one of us? Is he gay boy or straight boy? Might be a bit young for me, do you think? Very nice pictures there. I do love those pictures very much that you've got there. Thank you very much for sending them through. All right. Now, let me just... Now, I've done something wrong here. Oh, gosh. What have I done there? 1 minute. Oh, a couple of messages coming through. I shall be with you in a second. Message, people. Oh, that's that one, isn't it? That's it there. Have I done that right now? Yep, that's it. Right, come back to me. Come back. There you are. I'm coming back so I can love you. And talking of love... Someone I love very much is my nephew, Jimmy Butler. Good morning, Jimmy Butler, who's just messaged in. Jimmy Butler's 16 years old. And now with a moped, which is broken. But do not worry, it is being fixed. Yeah, Jimmy was out on his, he's got this bike that he got for his birthday. I can't remember, did Mum and Dad buy you the bike or did you buy it yourself? Can't remember now. Anyway, got this moped for his birthday. I think it's a 50... Tell me what it is. Is it a... I think it's a 50cc... is it a Honda or what is it? Tell us, Jimmy. Anyway, it's gone wrong already. Oh, what's a shame. Because he painted it all red. And something went wrong with the paint. Some sort of chemical reaction. And the paint then all bubbled up on the bike. So he had to sand it all down. Or with, I suppose, wire wool. I don't know what you use to do that. I don't do anything like that. Jimmy can do all these things because his dad taught him. And he sands it all down and repainted it red and it was all going well. And all of a sudden it broke down and apparently the pistons stopped working or went bang or something like that. Anyway, Jimmy Butler has now bought new pistons. And I believe they arrived today, do they? Have you managed to fix it yet? Do let Uncle Chris know. Thank you. I want, oh, here we, oh, message coming through. Instant message. I love the Skype. We love the Skype. Message coming through. What does it say? Oh, sorry. The sounds have started again. Don't mean that to happen. Oh, we're waiting for the message. Come on, Jimmy. Type faster. Type faster. By the way, you can join in, boys and girls. If you have just switched on today, then please let me know. My email address, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. You can give us a call on Skype if you want. Skype username, all one word, Chris Reardon. Okay? Chris Reardon is a Skype username. And indeed, phone in as well. On the phone, 020-8133-6358. Local London number. 020-8133-6358. Jimmy says, Mum bought the bike and some of the bits have come. It's a 50cc Gilera runner. Are you a motorbiker? Do you know? 50cc Gilera. She's going to fix that soon. Bits have come. Soon you will be mobile again. It's the Jimmy Butler mobile. We love it. We love it, yes. Good morning, Jimmy. Thank you for sending poor old Uncle Chris, who ages by the minute, a little message like that. And we also say good morning to Marj in Oklahoma. Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the rain. Marj is with us this morning in Oklahoma. Good morning, Marj. And Marj indeed sent in a couple of messages about the car. Sorry, the cat, not the car, the cat. The cat last week, because I said to you, I got an email from, a letter actually in the post, from the vets, who have said they've got a special offer on for flea injections. Now, I never knew such a thing existed, but you can have your cat be given an injection, okay, against fleas, and this works for 6 months. 6 months, fleas, no fleas. And I said, what did people think? Now, since then, I have rung vet. I said, can you tell me how much it is? She said, well, it depends. If you have, I don't understand this. If you have the nurse give her the injection, it's £42. If the vet does it, it's £55. I mean, it's the same bloody thing, isn't it? Whether it's the vet or the nurse doing it. Very strange. Oh, Marge says it's only 42 degrees in Oklahoma. Is that freezing? Because they talk Fahrenheit there. They still do. I'd still do a bit of Fahrenheit. Kind of above O, I do above freezing. I do Fahrenheit. Below freezing, I do centigrade. Strange, isn't it? That's because when I was at school, they were kind of crossing over between metric and imperial measurements. So in my head, some of my measurements in my head are imperial, and some of them are metric. Anyway, I have thought about this cat injection at the moment. I've got the little thing that you squeeze on the back of her neck, you know? And that seems to work all right. I mean, I don't have fleas, because years ago, I mean, I shouldn't really tell you this. It does make me feel dirty. No one listening. Years ago, I had a flea problem in the house. And of course, it must have come from the cat, not the one I've got now. Oh, it was awful. And eventually I was getting bitten. You'd be sitting there. It's terrible. You'd be sitting there watching a telly in shorts because it was a very hot summer. And I felt a flea jump on my leg and I looked down and as I looked, it jumped off again. Anyway, so I ignored it for a couple of days. Well, after that, this was happening often. You know, you'd be sitting there and a flea would jump on. An hour later, another one would drop on. And apparently, if just one jumps on you, that means there are X number in the house. Anyway, cut a long story short, because I've told this one before. I went to the vets, got this spray, sprayed the house, closed all the doors. I mean, sprayed everywhere in the house, every single room. Closed all the doors, went to work, come back. And when I opened the door, all these dead things were everywhere. There were spiders, flies and everything on the carpet. Oh, it's awful. And I never came back again. Never ever had the problem since, and that's going back. Oh, that must be going back 15 years. That I felt so dirty. I thought, how disgusting that I've got fleas in the house. But you know, it's just one of those things, and if it happens to you, you have to deal with it. And then when that does happen to you, do deal with it. Write to me, and I can tell everyone on here that you've got a dirty house. Can't I? Oh, Marj, Jimmy, Marj says they don't make 50cc. It's actually 49cc. And they put 50cc on the side. Because Marj has got a bike. What bike have you got, Marj? Or you'd get on well with Marj, Jimmy. Marj has got... Marj, can I ring you? Can we have a little chat about bikes? Do you mind? Just going to give you a little call now because Jimmy will be interested. I don't know if Jimmy's still with us. He might have just waited for his little mention and then disappeared and left poor old Uncle Chris alone again. I'm just guessing that. Right, I think we should have Marj. Good morning, Marj.
Hello.
Hello, how are you today? Marj? Have you gone?
Hang on.
Oh, there you are.
Hang on. No, I'm here. Am I here?
Yep, you're there.
Okay, I'm sorry. I have to always turn off the video thing. I don't know if I'm going to be breaking up. Let me close the browser here. Okay, now I'm
that's
here.
That's working very well this morning, Marj.
Okay. Yeah, I'm kind of under the weather this morning. I got into some weeds and weed eating and kind of got me sick.
Weed eating?
Yeah, I don't mean I eat the weeds. I mean...
That's what I thought you were...
No, I got weed. We call it weed. I don't know. Do y'all weed eat?
I don't like the sound of that. Eating weeds, Marj.
That don't make me laugh.
Although you can eat some stuff. You can eat seaweed, can't you?
Yeah. It might be good for you.
Is it all seaweed or just certain types?
Kelp, I guess. I take kelp in you can eat alfalfa.
Right.
But no, I don't eat the alfalfa bales, but no. No, I did a bunch of yard work this week and I'm highly allergic to those dandelions.
Oh yes.
And yeah. You know, and certain weeds I call them stink weeds. I don't know what the real name is. I'm not sick. I just feel kind of like a mild malaise, but anyway.
Queasy. Bit queasy.
Sorry.
Queasy.
We would use the term queasy. It's in my stomach. Actually, I feel like I got itchy ants running all over my body.
Oh, no.
Yeah, kind of itchy feeling. I'm kind of worried, too. My dog's got to go to surgery next week. Oh. So, not worried, but I mean, you know how it is when you got a family member who's got to go into the hospital.
As you well know, at Christmas time with my cat.
Yeah, I bawled over that. But no, this here is not—it's not really anything extreme. She's got a fatty tumor on her chest, and it's one of them old age. But see where it's at? It's going to be pushing in on her heart and her lungs and stuff. And so I got to rake up about $200. It's pretty cheap, $200. I mean, he's doing it really extremely cheap for me. But you know, it's my baby, and anyway, so I got to get her through that. So. Other than that, nothing much else going on. Oh, it's cold here. God.
Oh, it's not here.
Is it cold there?
No, we're having some wonderful weather at the moment. We're getting to about 70, 72 maybe. Good. Yeah, it's really, the last 3 days have been exceptionally nice. The only thing is, Marj, over the last few years, we've had this. We've had 2 or 3 weeks of really nice weather, and then that's it.
Well, it's been a roller coaster here. I mean, day before yesterday, it was 90 degrees. I don't know what that is in Celsius, but next town is, that's hot.
Yeah.
I mean, and then last night, it was 31. Now, that's crazy.
That's
snow
a huge
in Kansas.
Difference.
Snow on May 1st.
That's a
in
huge
Kansas.
Difference.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on. I think Mom Nature is having a mid-age crisis or something. Menopause.
How do you heat your house, Marj?
I have an electric box.
Right.
That hangs on. You've ever seen, I don't know if you have them there. Like, you see them in offices, all these buildings like mechanics and stuff have. They're up in the corner of the building.
Oh,
you know, you see a little square.
Air conditioning. Yeah, I have one in this room.
This is inside the house. I mean, it's electric. It's got, it looks like a coiled thing inside of a box.
Yes.
It's a strange setup, but it works. I mean, I heat the house instantly, you know. Yeah. I mean, just in a few seconds, the whole house is hot. So, and I don't run it that much. I can leave it on. It's got a temperature, you know, where you set it like a certain place, because it's hard to judge because it doesn't have a gauge. You don't know, you know, you have to just judge at how to set it. And, That's how I heat. It costs about $100 a month. That's the only bad thing when I run it. So
yeah, is that the only way you've got heating? You haven't got a wood thing or anything like that?
No, I'm in a camper. Remember, I was in a trailer that I had a wood stove, and I hated it. One time the stovepipe got too much creosote. We call it. You know, that buildup. It's creosote, and it caught on fire. My stovepipe was on fire.
I think we call it paraffin.
Paraffin.
It's known as paraffin here.
Yeah. I always thought we call paraffin like that saran wrap you put on your sandwiches.
So tell me, Marj, what bike have you got? Because Jimmy would be interested in this, my nephew Jimmy. What bike do you have?
I wish he was here. I'd give him mine. It's a 49. They're called 49cc. You said 50. Right. They're really 49cc. Okay. And it's a Eton Beamer.
Is that what you've got?
Uh-huh. Eton Beamer. It's a 2005. Yeah. His bike is nice. So I saw that picture. Mine has a brain box, a little box. It went bad once already, and it went bad again. It's got electrical trouble. It's just sitting out in the backyard now. Right. I hated that because I loved riding that little thing.
And that's 49cc as well. Is it your one?
They all make 49. They're all 49. Okay. You hear 50, but they're really actually 40. I don't know. It's no big deal, but I mean, they're 49cc.
And how fast does that go then, Marge?
Well, if you'll nip that little green wire under the brain box, you can go 50, but that's illegal in some states.
Right.
It's got a governor on the brain box,
okay,
a little square box. I don't know if that they legally make you stay at 30 miles per hour, I think is what they usually say, but it's 50cc. It should go, with him being lightweight, he should probably go 50.
Yeah,
or 45 or 50, but that's really, you know, you have to be careful because that's a lightweight vehicle, you know. Big puff of wind can knock you over into the ditch.
Right, okay.
But mine's bright yellow. I think his was blue or something.
Yeah, I think the roads would be very different to where you are because he'd be driving on a road with a lot of cars going past.
Yeah.
It's a different setup altogether, you know, some of them dual carriageways.
Yeah.
Which means two roads.
I would have got him a really a bike, like a 150, 250, because you ever have a car coming at you, you can't get out of the way fast.
Right.
I mean, unless you head to the ditch. I mean, that's the reason I got my 250, because, you know, people are not respectful of you, but they may be better over there. Here, they just like, get out of my way.
What's the 250 you've got there? What make is that?
My Honda Rebel.
Honda Rebel, okay.
Rebel, uh-huh. It's a 2004.
Yeah.
And I bought it. It was 600 miles, and it's got 28,000 miles since I bought it. And it's not giving me any trouble. That is the greatest starter bike for anybody, you know. Of course, they do make 150 other, you know, motorcycles. But like I said, to really get into traffic, you need something that you can get maneuverable. And plus the wind, you know, a big puff of wind can pretty well knock you plumb out into the ditch. So anyway, it's a nice bike.
What is it again? A Honda? Because I'm going to look this up later as well. A Honda.
Honda Rebel.
Right.
And
Honda 250. Rebel 250, is it?
Now, the next one up, after you get used to riding a motorcycle, is the Shadow.
Right.
Now, also, you know, of course, if you got the money, Harley-Davidson makes a small bike.
Okay.
And I don't think there's 700 is small on them, but Harley-Davidson... There's a saying here, it's hardly under $100 any part that you buy on a Harley. I mean, it's $100.
Just having a look now at the What was it again? Honda Rebel 250.
Honda 250.
I think I can bring that picture up, actually. Let's just try and... You haven't got the video on now, have you?
Well, I turned it off, but let me turn
it
back.
I thought
I'd buffer.
That's all right, because you know what it looks like. Other people won't know.
Yeah,
I'm just bringing up a picture of a Honda Rebel there. Hopefully people can see that.
Now, mine's black, and they come in blues, of course, any color you want.
Right.
I want a purple one next time. I may paint it purple.
You could paint that one, couldn't you?
Yeah, I'm crazy. I'm a hippie, you know. I like colors.
Yeah.
I wanted to paint my van purple, but, you know, I haven't done it yet. I want purple with yellow flowers, you know.
It looks very nice, the bike, I must say. It's quite long, isn't it? It's long.
Well, it may look that way, but it looks like a regular... People think it's like a 700,
right,
or, you know, a regular bike. It looks like a real motorcycle. It is a real motorcycle.
Yeah.
But, you know, you tell them it's 250, and they say, oh, okay. You know, and another thing, it gets 80 miles per gallon. I don't know how to convert that
80
over,
miles
but...
As I was saying, Marge, in my head, I have imperial measurements... some imperial and some metric. I'm very much gallons. Yeah.
Well, I mean, with your viewers, it'd be nice if I could instantly say, okay, this is so much. I may sit here and learn that
way.
They
know what gallons are. We know what gallons are here. It's just the blooming Europeans that keep trying to change us all the time, dear.
Yeah. A petrol. I mean, I don't know how many petrols it has, and you know.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I've got a diesel car, and I'm getting 65 to 70 miles a gallon out of that, and that's pretty good.
Wow.
Yeah, I drive very carefully, Marge. Yeah.
Is your diesel, is it higher than the regular?
Yes.
I don't understand that.
It used to be... generally, the price difference between petrol and diesel is between 5 and 10 pence. So between 8 and 15 cents difference between a gallon.
How much would it be like a gallon there? I mean, it's almost $4.
We have
here.
Some of the most expensive fuel in the world. A gallon of of diesel is about £1.40. So that would be $2.20 for one gallon.
Oh, that's cheap. Dang. It's $3.89 a gallon here.
Oh, no, hang on a minute. No, I'm going the wrong way here.
Oh, okay.
Sorry. £1. I don't know what... I can do a conversion. 1 minute. Convert. So what were you going to do? Convert... pounds to dollars. Ah, now that's right. I've got this wrong. They sell petrol in liters now.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I can kind of understand liters because we get 3 liter bottles of Coke and stuff. You know,
right.
I can kind of guesstimate what a liter is.
So, how many liters in a gallon? I'm not sure. Hang on, Oh, I don't know. 1 liter, liters. What are we doing? Liters to gallons. So liters to gallons. There we are. So 1 gallon is equal to 4.5 liters. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Yeah.
One liter of diesel is about £1.40. So we say $2.
Oh, okay. It's about the same then.
No, it's not. It's not the same at all.
Not?
No. So £1. Let me convert that. So then we do.
But don't let. I can't figure in my head anyway.
So if I do, what we're going to do? No, not that one. Liters to gallons. Okay. Pounds, so £1.40 in dollars is $2.18. Okay, so $2.18, right? We'll call it $2.20. All right,
all right,
right. times 4.5. So, are you ready for this?
Oh, wow.
Oh,
why?
Yes.
In it?
Oh, yes. Right, hang on a minute. I'll do this for you. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10. Okay. 1 litre, 1 gallon of diesel here is about $10.90.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
Wow. Oh, that's ridiculous.
Yeah.
And it's a good thing that you get good gas mileage. I mean, I can believe that.
Yeah.
I mean, from it's $4. It was $3.89 a gallon.
Yeah.
And yours is $10. Wow.
$10, nearly $11.
Oh, man. Golly.
A lot of money, isn't it?
I would be riding my bike.
Hey?
A lot. I'd be riding a bicycle or walking or I couldn't
I ride a bicycle during the daytimes all the time, Marj.
You know, I looked at a bicycle at a garage sale the other day, and I thought about you.
Oh,
I said,
yeah.
You know, I need to get back on a bicycle. It was $40. I should have bought it. I didn't.
Yeah, you
but...
should have. Jimmy says he'd like one of the bikes that you've got in yellow.
Yeah, that's why I said if he were here, I'd give him this one just to play with. He could probably fix it.
So the acceleration.
But you're not in Oklahoma.
So the acceleration is. Well, that's what he's doing. He's got into college to do car body work, I think.
I've done that. I used to work in a body shop.
All right, yeah. I'm not much good at that. And I want to send him my. I'm going to get him to do my mirror at some point on the car.
That's good. Well, that's handy to have somebody in the family. Yeah, I've worked like a guy my whole life. I was in a, you know, mechanics helper and service in a service department. My dad was a mechanic. You know, I was actually the one that did the taping and a lot of the buffing, getting it ready in the puck and the little putty stuff. And I didn't do major things. You know, the body part. I wasn't good at that yet, but I've done it all: welding, you know, you name it.
Well,
didn't get to work like a girl. I've always worked like a guy.
Well, there's nothing wrong with that.
No, it's nothing. I just mentioned it. I wouldn't mean it was wrong.
You enjoy doing that work. I think it's fantastic.
Yeah.
I'm not too good with anything like that. I've not got a lot of patience, Marj.
You can't change a tire, can you?
No, I can't.
I'm just kidding.
I can change
those
a tire.
Tires are,
you know, Marj, years ago, about 8 years ago, I had a Land Rover.
Yeah.
The army types, you know, the square ones.
Yeah.
And I was going up to my sister's on a Christmas Eve, and I've gone round a corner and hit a curb, and I've got a flat on the Land Rover. So I had to change the tyre. Let me tell you, it was really difficult because they're so heavy, you know?
Yeah.
And
yeah,
I ended up...
Oh, yeah, some of them are.
I had to sit on the... Well, I wasn't too far away from my sister's house. I had to sit on the grass and with my legs push up the new tyre and at the same time trying to jiggle with my hands to get on the nuts.
Yeah, I've kicked them on each side and kicked them on and kicked them off.
Yeah,
But, like, I think as a video I was watching, it, you had the... They do like they do here. They tighten those lug nuts, that we call them lug nuts,
right?
Too tight, and you
That's
can't
right,
break.
Yeah.
I mean, I had an extra bar.
Yeah.
You know, I had my wrench, and then I have a pipe.
Yeah.
To get put on the end of the wrench.
Yeah.
That's the only way I could ever get my tire off.
Because the last time I did that, that was the exact thing happened. I couldn't get it off. In fact, where the just a minute.
Hey, phone calling.
Oh, you know, this is Ronny. Hang on. Ronny, you're on speakerphone to the entire world.
Hello?
You're on speakerphone.
Oh, hello.
Good morning.
Hello to all of your 5 listeners.
Say hello to Marj in Oklahoma.
Hello, Marj in Oklahoma.
Hello, Ron.
What can I do for you?
I've just on my way over to you, dear.
Oh, okay. Let yourself in. Have you got the keys?
Yeah, I've just
going to
drop a plant off for you. The garden has been.
Okay. Can you bring
tea
up?
I'm driving over to you. I've just driven over to you. I've got the roof down. The sun is shining. Oh, it's just such a lovely day here.
Well, hurry up, dear. Bring the cup of tea up with you.
Well, I can't stop here. I've got to get to my mother's.
Aren't we having a cup of tea?
Well, maybe. I'll see you another time.
Okay.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Oh, he's bringing over a plant for me. He knows I like plants. Marge, you were saying, yeah, those lugs. I don't know what we call it. We call them nuts. Nuts. They go on the nuts and bolts.
We call them lug nuts.
So the nut is the screw bit. The bolt is the long bit. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And then there's a loose nut behind the wheel.
Yeah, the last time I did it, I couldn't get it off. I had to call the AA people out in the end because the brace was actually breaking. I got to the point where it just wouldn't. So I started jumping on it, didn't I? And then it broke.
Yes.
The brace just broke. Yeah, I couldn't get it off. But they do them up with those machines, you know. You know, those machines. Yeah.
I know, I've done it myself. I always tell them not to do it that tight, you know, because I want to make sure I can, you know, if I'm off somewhere, I don't have AAA or whatever you call it. I forgot what you call it there.
AA.
It's AAA.
Well, we have a few people. There's the AA, there's the RAC, we've got Green Flag and a few independents, yes.
I don't mean any offense to anybody, but sometimes I go, I mean, I'm a woman, and you have somebody come up, like some men, you know, they don't know anything about cars, and they want to help you.
Yeah.
It's better just to leave me alone, because actually, they cause more damage. I had a guy trying to help me, and he knocked off the cable off of my battery, and I said, sir, I know what's wrong with my car. I appreciate you offering to help, but I've got it under control, you know.
I can understand that, Marge. Yeah.
Some people are just too helpful, you know. And but they see a woman, you know, most of the time, you know, automatically it's like, oh, she don't know what she's doing, you know. But I normally, if I do need help, I just call somebody, you know, my mechanic. Yeah.
Now, I'm going to wrap this show up in a minute. But I just wanted to read an email. We were talking about the cat injections just before you were called in there.
Yeah,
and you sent in
my mother is totally against that. Because
you sent in this email, and it said, and you said, if it were my old cat like Katie, because she is old, I wouldn't use injectable. It shows safe, but as you read on it, I found these adverse reactions. The following adverse reactions were observed in clinical trials with the 6-month injection for cats. Pain on injection site lumps, vomiting, listlessness, lethargy and anorexia. Histolytic examination of one of cat's injection site lump showed evidence of inflammation surrounding an area of necrosis, is it?
Mm-hmm.
With marked proliferation of fibrous connective tissue. In another cat, granulomatous inflammation was noted, which included non-pleomorphic fibrositis and fibroplasia. So, I think...
Well, I just said if, you know, you're taking a chance, she's old.
Yeah.
You know, and it may not do anything. But, I mean, my mother, especially, she's got 16 cats. She says, no way I would use that.
Yeah,
I mean, we use the drops and stuff like you're talking about. Yeah. But, I mean, you had no problems with the drops.
No,
I mean, it's up to you. I mean, I just seen, read up on it. I said, anything you're putting in their body, of course, the drops go, it absorbs into their neck. So, I just thought you hadn't seen that. I thought maybe you might be interested in reading it. Since she is so old, you know, you don't have a flea problem, do you? Very bad, and
not at all. I've never found any on her. Never.
Well, as long as you're keeping your yard clean, and she doesn't go off anywhere, does she? She just goes in the backyard.
Oh, she goes. No, she goes out. Yeah, she goes.
Oh,
out.
Does
I don't
she?
Know where she goes to? You know what cats are like. They do their own thing, and they come back when they want to.
Oh. I thought maybe your yard was like where she couldn't get out, you know, like those briar. You got that bush over there that's real sharp. I thought that was all around your yard. So.
It is.
But
it
mostly,
is, but she,
mostly
but
they go
out,
way off, you know.
There's a cat flap as well. She goes out there at the front door. She goes for little walks. Yeah, she's all right.
Okay.
She's happy.
It's amazing she's lived this long. Mostly cats sometimes get out and, you know, they get into trouble sometimes.
Know,
but you're probably not by a major highway or anything like that.
Well, I lost one cat to a dog.
That's what I mean. They're exposed to whatever's out there.
She lost her head.
Oh, goodness.
I never found her head. That's a few years ago now. And my mate lost a cat. It got run over. Bless it.
See, all my cats, they have their own house. and they have the enclosure, a big area, you know, that they stay in. And so,
yes,
because I've got, they kill my birds, you know, and I'm right here by the road.
Yeah.
So if I want to keep my cat, I keep them. It sounds bad, but they're happy. They're all fat and lazy, and I go out and sit with them in their little area. They got things to sleep in and play in, you know, toys, I think they're pretty content.
Good.
But if I want to keep my birds, I have to keep my cats up.
Of course. Marj,
well, hon,
before you go, I must apologize. Yeah. I'm sorry that we're going down to one show a week for the summer, but it's just so nice out there.
Oh, I was just kidding you on the Facebook there. I was just telling you how I'll miss the two nights a week. I wasn't complaining. I don't complain at all.
I
understand you get busy, and like me, I'm starting to get busy, but...
Yeah.
That's
okay. I'm sure we'll be back to two in the autumn, which will probably come quicker than you can think.
Well, I'm still catching up. Heck, I'm still in 2008 on all your videos.
I know.
Except I enjoy the longer hair.
I've got to thank you for the advice on my Manicam, which I'm using today, which you probably
you
don't
are
realize
using
I'm
it.
Use
oh,
it.
Good.
And I upgraded to the Pro. Was that your cat or mine?
Oh, okay. What?
Is that your cat or mine meowing?
Meowing.
Was
Must
that your
be
cat?
You, because I don't have a cat in the house.
Was it not?
No, I don't have a cat in the house.
Katie?
Must be Katie.
Katie?
I hear her, yeah.
No, she's not meowing.
Well, I hear
it
too.
I don't know what you're hearing. It must be your end.
Well, it's not here. It's on. I'm hearing it through the... We've got a spook.
All right. Well, nice talking to you, Marj. Always a pleasure.
Okay. Got to go back to sleep, so I can go to work today.
Sleep
have a good
then.
One.
Yeah, I know what time it is. About 7 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah, I got to get my beauty sleep.
Come
I don't,
7 o'clock.
I'd have to sleep 24 hours a day to get any beauty sleep.
I think I'd have to sleep 48.
Beauty out of my sleep.
See you,
have
Marj.
A good day.
Oh, hang on.
Bye-bye.
Cheerio.
Bye now.
There we are, Marj from Oklahoma. And that's where we shall wrap it up today. Thanks very much for watching and listening to the show, boys and girls. Once again, if you're watching or listening to the recording, then don't forget, do send us an email. My email address is chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. If you want to join us live, you can do so, and you can call in just as Marj did then, either by Skype or telephone. The live show is on Friday mornings at 10:30 UK time. And to find the direct link for that, simply go to the main United Kingdom Talk website, unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. And right at the very top there will be a link to the show. And if I'm not wrong, I can hear Ron coming up the stairs now. Is it you? Are you coming up the stairs? Hello? Don't know if he's coming up the stairs or not. Just a minute. Are you there? No, he's not. He's not here yet. Never mind. So he's not quite made it in time. Anyway, I'll see you again soon. Thanks so much for watching and listening. Once again, my email address, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.